We do have the capacity to keep ourselves centered in sanity, even during these incredibly trying times. So the means to do this is what we're calling the continuity problem exercise. And this is the form of the exercise. I don't have a dot, dot, dot problem. And you fill in the dot, dot, dot with, for instance, touchy problem. I don't have some real touchy problem that I don't have a touchy problem. I have a continuity problem. The touchy problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value. So we're going to go over a list of words. And these words are going to describe sort of the feel of a problem, right? Like, this is a really touchy problem. You know, how do I resolve this very touchy problem? We say we don't have a touchy problem. We have a continuity problem. The touchy problem has no value to us. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. So I say, I don't have a delicate problem. I have a continuity problem. The delicate problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I don't have a dangerous problem. I have a continuity problem. The dangerous problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I don't have an iffy problem. I have a continuity problem. The iffy problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I don't have a tough problem. I have a continuity problem. The tough problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I don't have a challenging problem. I have a continuity problem. The challenging problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me, because only the vision of oneness resolves my one and only problem, which is the continuity problem. I don't have a troublesome problem. I have a continuity problem. The troublesome problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I don't have an intricate problem. I have a continuity problem. The intricate problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I don't have an exacting problem. I have a continuity problem. The exacting problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value. I don't have a problematical problem. I have a continuity problem. The problematical problem has absolutely no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I do not have a crucial problem. I have a continuity problem. The crucial problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I do not have a difficult problem. I only have a continuity problem. The difficult problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I do not have a complicated problem. I only have a continuity problem. The complicated problem has absolutely zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I do not have an oppressive problem. I have a continuity problem. The oppressive problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I do not have a trying problem. I have a continuity problem. The trying problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I do not have a weighty problem. I have a continuity problem. The weighty problem has absolutely no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I don't have a ticklish problem. I have a continuity problem. The ticklish problem has zero value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I don't have an entangled problem. I have a continuity problem. The entangled problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. Only the vision of oneness resolves my one and only problem, which is the continuity problem. I do not have a perplexing problem. I have a continuity problem. The perplexing problem doesn't have any value at all for me. The vision of oneness, only the vision of oneness has value to me. I do not have a puzzling problem. I have a continuity problem. The puzzling problem doesn't have any value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me. I don't have a taxing problem. I have a continuity problem. The taxing problem has no value to me. Only the vision of oneness has value to me, because only the vision of oneness resolves the one and only problem I have, which is the continuity problem. If it weren't for the continuity problem, the very next instant, the very next moment, we would literally set down the idea of trying to change reality, and all our problems would simply not arise at all, vanish, gone, because time, space, form, bodies, personalities, ego, all would not arise, would not be there in the next moment. But because we're so used to defining success as success at failure, trying to work on this imaginary scenario of reality failing to be what it is, which is what we're perceiving and think we're experiencing in existence. We're so used to that. We're so used to being miserable and fearful. We're terrified of true happiness, which is undefined, which is unaffected by anything whatsoever that we should choose to experience. Our true happiness comes from our true freedom. We're terrified of it. We think it's an abyss. We think it's an abyss. We think we'll fall into some abyss. We will not. We will be floating in total support of pure happiness. But we don't see it that way yet. So therefore, we have a severe continuity problem. We have no choice but to set down the idea of failure, the idea that we can cause reality to fail to be what it is. We have no choice but to set that down, no choice at all, because we can't accomplish it. It's impossible. So there's nothing to do except set it down. And yet we cling to it because of the continuity problem. And because we cling to it, we have all these other problems, and yet they're not real problems, are they? Because with just setting the idea down, they're all gone. Idea of failure down, they're all gone together, all at once. So our only problem is our fear of setting it down, which means the continuity problem. We don't set it down because we're jittery about pure happiness, you know, non-localized, process-free, unaffected, uncaused, inherent, pure happiness, undefined. We're afraid of that, you know, so we don't set it down. But we can definitely get to where we evaporate the fear of it, of setting it down, which is what we have to do. We have no choice in the matter. So we apply this continuity practice technique, which opens the door. It evaporates the fear, more and more fear. We concentrate on the vision of oneness. We concentrate on it. We put all our efforts there to solving this problem, because by solving this problem, all other problems will vanish for sure. Okay. Very great. That's it for this practice video.